Yeah, Windows 12 is gonna be a thing. Although it may not be called as Windows 12 as such, I think they are calling it codename Hudson Valley. The exact reason why they don't want to call it Windows 12 is unclear. One rationale is that they don't want to divide their audience base or user base even more. And that's a strange reason to give, in my opinion, because they already said once that Windows 10 would be the final one, and then they announced in 2021 that Windows 10 will reach its service end in 2025, with securities ending in 2028. So when you've already announced it and you released a freaking OS called Windows 11, why not call this Windows 12? It's pretty clear with Microsoft's intent that the biggest feature we'll see with this Hudson Valley project is with AI, particularly around all of the copilots that they have built. Aside from Bing AI, which is now called just Copilot for your browser, there is Windows AI and then AI built into MS Office itself. And some of those features are already being released to like developer builds of Windows 11. Those who are in dev channels have already gotten some of those updates quite recently. Microsoft may be playing a sneaky game here, giving those Windows 12 updates to Windows 11 users just to test it out without telling them it's a new OS update. Those features are available in 23H2 build, which is not the same as the classic 22H2 which most people are running. Also, with this new Hudson Valley project, they are reverting back to their annual updates, which means you'll have one big update every year with smaller updates sprinkled throughout. That's how they used to do it before they changed it, and now they are back. Okay, we are expecting this Hudson Valley OS to come out in April 2024 to commercial devices, and then later on in the year for like business users. Devices powered by Qualcomm chipsets will probably be getting this OS first, because they rely on the germanium platform that this OS uses. There are some really nice concept videos made by, you know, people, fans in general, of Windows 12, and they do seem kind of in line with what Microsoft might do. The UI will be a lot more dynamic, we'll have more options for widgets, just like we did back in Windows Vista and Windows 7 days. Not to mention we'll have the Copilot across Windows, which I think will be a convenient feature. It'll be like a much more efficient version of Cortana that's actually useful. The exact system requirements are not clear yet. Microsoft might bump up the RAM requirement from 4GB to 8GB according to some reports, but it's not official yet. So we should be fine. I assume the extra RAM is required for all the new AI stuff that's going on. That's all fine. I just hope they don't make it too bloated and unstable. You know, Windows 11 is already not a great experience compared to how reliable Windows 10 has been. That's the main reason why a lot of people still use Windows 10, for its reliability and predictable performance. Windows 11 hasn't quite reached that level yet, and they're already coming up with a kind of a placeholder for Windows 12, I guess. Not sure how it'll turn out, but they seem pretty confident in their AI stride, and I am excited to check it out as well. I'm an early adopter anyways. I installed Windows 11 even when it wasn't supported on my super old laptop. You know, I bypassed all that TPU requirement and everything. So I'll see what I can do. I'll check this out. Meanwhile, let me know what you think. Are you using Windows 11? What's your experience so far? And if Windows 12 comes out in the near future, will you upgrade?